In the previous video, I reviewed various options of BMS for my budget DIY EV conversion. And one of the versions that really attracted my attention was DIY BMS by Stuart Pittaway. So eventually I decided to go with this version and use it for my DIY budget EV conversion. Why did I decide to go with DIY BMS? There are a number of reasons. First reason, it's very open source, fully documented on GitHub by Stuart Pittaway. And also the other reason is that because I already made this version of DIY BMS before and I'm partially familiar with it. It can be manufactured by JLC PCB on fairly low budget. So where JLC PCB will make the boards and will do partial assembly for most of the components that are available. So let's see how I get on with ordering the parts. Hello, I'm Ed. The challenge I set myself is to build an electric car conversion on the budget. Therefore, I was choosing components for my project very carefully. Now that I have a motor spinning in the sine mode and performed an FOC tuning, I need to configure battery, and for this I will require a BMS, battery management system. I went to Stuart Pittaway GitHub page, and he has a number of repositories for DIY BMS. And I started from DIY BMS version 4 repository. So this is where we have modules, controller, etc., etc. So I went to download the code and just downloaded the zip file. So let's have a look, what do we have in this repository? We have a new module, V440 module. We can have a look at the PCB here. So basically this is our new module. As you can see, it has 80 tiny, does read the battery and controls the FET, etc. So now once we've downloaded this, we can go onto JLC PCB website. And we can upload the design. If we go to add Gerber file, and we need to navigate to our DIY BMS repository. And in this case, I will start from doing the module manufacture. So in that folder here, we should have a Gerber somewhere. There you go, that's a Gerber folder. And we just need to grab the Gerber.zip file. Go to Gerber and just drag it into there. And straight away, we're uploading the Gerber files, and it gives you roughly the calculated price. So we have a nice preview of our little module. So we're using FR4 dimensions, two-layer PCB. You can choose the color. I'll stay with green, I don't know, maybe a fancy black. And now we're gonna go for PCB assembly. So we're gonna go for economic, top sight, and in this case, PCB quantity. Because I've selected only 5 PCBs, I will go for 10, I think, in this case. So then now we have PCB quantity 10, and we assemble the top side, tooling holes added by JLC PCB. So I'm happy with that. We're not gonna have anything in the bottom. Right, so now I confirmed terms and conditions, and it took me to a different screen where I need to add bill of materials and assembly pick and place file. So Stuart kindly provided them as well. So I'm just going to go to, so we are in Gerber folder. Now we go back to module folder, and we should have CSV file, which is, which one is it? Yeah, of course it's an obvious name called module V440 bill of material JLC. And now all we need to do is add a placement file. So placement file is CPL JLC PCB, open, and that's done as well. And now they're required to tell you what do you want to use this product for. So I'm gonna go for DIY option, and I'm gonna go next. Now, tune, 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 we have our BOM loaded, and surprise, surprise, we do have inventory shortage. Okay, we'll see if we can actually find substitutes and resolve the inventory shortage issue. Let's search for the resistor value. So it's 3.3 ohms and I go for 750 milliwatts. So we have number of choices. I've ticked in stock option here. So let's have a look what we have. For some reason, it's picking up 3.3 kiloohms in this case. That's, we don't need that. And then 13.3 kiloohm. And 13.3 ohm. Don't need that. And now I think we have what we need. We have 750 milliwatt thick film resistor, 3.3 ohm and 2010 package. So what we're going to do is we're going to copy this value and go to this. So we have 224 in stock. Is that the one we were looking at? So let's look at this one. So this one is also 3.3 ohm, but there's actually more of them in stock. So it's 750. It's less accurate, plus minus 5%. Well, I think I want to go for more accurate one, for 1%. So let's just copy JLC PCB part number. We just paste. So it's extended part, unfortunately, but it's 1%. And we have 121 in stock. So we're happy with that choice. And let's look at this diode. Okay, this is alternative part and it's offering me this as a replacement. So let's look at the one we have selected here. So let's download the tech sheet. So things we care about is basically overall power, the mount transient voltage suppressor, and the package SMD DO 2014. So 65.2 amps, 9.2 volts. So if we press search, let's see what is offering us as a replacement. So let's look at this one. So this one has similar characteristics, 600 watts, 65.2 amps and 9 voltage. I think this pretty much is suitable for us. Let's look at the package. Yeah, it's a similar DO214AA package. Yeah, it's a very similar, and the current peak forward surge current 100 amps. Peak forward surge current 100 amps. It's pretty much, I would say, spot on choice for us as a replacement. Okay, so I'm happy with this choice. So I'm going to select that. And all we have is the problem with AT Tiny. Yeah, unfortunately, we have only one in stock. So we have to go ahead with that. So now we go next, and that's pretty much everything is there. Just shows what is not ordered, various connectors. JST connectors, etc. So they don't have them. So I will be happy with that. So I will save it to cart. So that will be total price of £38.26. And now we need to find a controller. So to find the controller, we're gonna go back to our DIY BMS 4 master folder, and we have two folders: ASP8266 controller circuit. And this, I believe, it's an older version of the controller. So if we look at the PCB, so yeah, this is the one with the V4 controller circuit there. I actually already have this one, but this time I want to make a newer version, which is this one, I think. And well, let's have a look at the PCB. Where is the PCB gone? Ah, okay, of course it's out of my field of view. Fantastic. So yeah, that's a newer controller circuit, version 4.2. So I think I want to try make this one. Yeah, so this is now using ESP32 development kit here, and also Stuart added relays and as well as some CAN bus communication devices and RS485. Also, he did add ISP programmer. So he basically built in ASP in that module. So effectively, controller now can program individual modules. So that's I think it's very, very useful feature. At least in my opinion. So right,
So now we need to find the Gerbus. The Gerbus would be one of the export folders here, I think. And here we go, there is a folder called Gerbus. So we do have controller ESP32 Gerbus zipped file, which we're gonna drag in here and upload it. So calculated price, industrial consumer electronics. So it's also two-layer PCB. So it's been uploaded successfully. I'm just gonna go for everything default. 1.6 PCB thickness. We're gonna go with lead. And how many do we want? We want to do five. Five is too much, but you know, we don't have any other choice, unfortunately. And we're gonna go for only two PCB assembled because I don't need five. So agree terms and conditions, confirm, and pretty much same job in this case. So we now need to find CPL, it's a placement, and we need to find BOM. So this is our bill of material, and now we need to undo placement file. So CPL placement file is effectively for pick and place machine, where it knows the center of each component and it can place it. Next. And now we're loading the parts, and of course we do have inventory shortage. So we do have 80 tiny. And we do have, again, the same as 3 ohm resistor. I wish I'd saved whatever I found. I will skip this bit, so you don't need to sit through all of that. I will find that later. And now we found the parts that were missing, and I can now save this to cart. All done, and now we can go to secure checkout.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. So if you want to see where my project started, you can have a look at video over there. And if you wanted to look at my BMS choices or what I considered before I chosen DIY BMS, please have a look at video over there. And I will see you on the next one.